Okay. We'll have to rest again before we go fight these cultists, because I have zero might now. Okay, cool. Too bad we had to buy it from her. At least we found the other one, right? Runic Blade of Tol Anor. Look at all the damage it does. Unfortunately, we can't even afford it. But could you... Oh, she's using this thing again? Here. I figured out that we can't actually use this, and because I have an inability in medium and heavy weapons, and that's heavy, I think, right? It's a medium weapon. See, I guess I was confused at some point. I thought we could use medium. So let's take this. See, this should go up there, right? Sheesh. It's gonna be a little better done. Let's put these together. Mirror casters. Okay, so she's using this. And we've lost the Phoenix. Phoenix note. Have you gone here, Motley's? I think so. Now, first thing we need more health, a way to heal. So I'm going to buy all three. It's important. That was what killed us. We could have healed and I ran out, so. Encephalic Rush, I already have three of them. This worked really well. That's what knocked that cultist down for quite a while. And he didn't get up for the rest of the, like, almost, yeah, the entire rest of the, battle, or what do you call it, the, crisis. So the Fleetfoot Moss is good for speed. Let's get one. Oh, these refined Fleetfoot Moss. Let's get one regular. So I have three and three, and this is for use in combat amplified. Let's buy one for now. Now I'm really kind of broke. I'm passing this, at least for now. What is this? Blood of the Elements. That'd be neat. It's only plus one though. The Wisp, I think I should get that. And I think I should get... this. It helps. 10 damage. Instead of 8 and 7, 10 and 10. Real nice for him. And they're both heavy weapons? Yeah, it works. So, that's a lot though. What does she have? She has a sting charge already. Medium range weapon. I don't know if she's, probably not getting that. That's a big difference, though. I don't know if she has... Hold on. She has an inability in medium weapons, so we're going to forego that for now. For Calistige. Points of might. I'll get one. Did I cancel it? I canceled it. There we go. And these are things that we gave her. I'm gonna do it, guys. I'm gonna just sell the rest of my oddities. I hate doing it. The boots. The war mask. I mean, I can always buy them back later, right? She'll still have them, I'm hoping. I'm going to hold on to this thing because this actually has a use. And it did help us, well, it didn't help us, but it gave us a different look at the sphere. The chromatic sphere, whatever it is, that we, like, put in the right entrance and take from the bottom and all this stuff, and we got this stuff out. It didn't really help with that. I'm thinking it might help with something. Antagonist. So whenever I finish the game, I'll look to see if there's any, like, Easter eggs or things I can do with these items or things I haven't otherwise thought of. He uses a medium melee weapon. 8 plus 4 damage. On crits. His is better. But I'm gonna hold on to this in case we come across some other character who's using medium melee, right? Globe of Zrul. I hate to get rid of these things, they're so cool. Light metal. Mycometal vine fragment. Brood's ears. I'm gonna hold on to that. I wanna look at that. Doesn't seem useful. Stillness cage. Ebon eyes is an artifact. Keeping all the artifacts, keeping the book, and this. Father Teller. All I see is my own face, yeah, because he's the face of the changing god. Okay, we have almost 1,000 now. So, I can buy this mystic marble, and the canister. I can buy this blade. He's gonna slay with that blade. I could use that buckler, right? I haven't messed with this thing at all. Oh, that's the knockdown thing. But he uses a regular shield. So I'll give him this buckler. Look at that. Done. Shield for Aratus. Oh, that's why I heal more. Is it? Critical hits. Oh wait, that's No, I'm on what's his name? I guess he didn't critical hit enough. That's still hurting him. Okay. Got the shield for him. I'm not sure I can even put anything there. Because this takes up two slots, I'm supposing. But as far as him... yeah, runic blade. Boom. Anything else? These are all the stuff we handed over. Let's look at any artifacts that might not be that useful. Still holding on to this. Holding on to that. Oh, we haven't sold this? Oh, because I wanted to look at that. Plus one training level in perception spell skill. Oh, so that's like... that's like this. Persuasion, that's perception. Okay. Well, the shadow flower is an oddity. Let's sell that then. I thought it was a mirror caster at first. This is... that could be useful at some point as well. Okay, so we still have 476. We got his sword. We got his shield. I want to find out if either of these two... let's get another, amplifier? No. Oh yeah, I want these. Concentrated spray flesh. Both. Okay. So now... let me just look at this. Can he... nope. Well, we're gonna put this on him. He still can't use a shield. Okay. What about her? Oh, she can! That helps. Unfortunately, we don't have any other shield for her. Nice. Now, she's got a regular shield. You can see it there. Pretty cool. And this is the quick ice axe. Pretty awesome. So I'm going to sell this. And the shield, obviously, is still of use. And this thing... which I want to kind of fix all these together here. Scrolling away here. Here we go. This thing, where is it? Oh, Ebon Eyes, no. Mirror casters. What's this thing? Yeah, we can't use it at all. So I'm gonna sell it. The brood's ears. Brood's ears. And they look like, yeah. They look like cables for jump starting cars, electrical cables. Sell. Boop. And did I ever get the wisp thing? No. That will use up the rest of our stuff. Yeah. You know, we have all this healing and stuff now, though. Hmm. If I get this, we're gonna have 98 shins. Nah. Well, okay. I'm gonna run back and check with him one more time.
Yes.
See if there's anything I could use. Yeah, what if I need the money to rest? Like, what if I need to rest in, like, wherever we are, the Endless Gate? Okay, so we are full now. Look at me with 20 intellect.
All right.
I don't know, for that amount of money, then again, we still have to sell that, the quick ice axe. So we have that. At least he's right outside the entrance here. 29 tombs. Is there some magical number that he'll reward us with something when we've gone to like 100 tombs or something like that? 201, not bad. Forgot about that. Okay, so we sold the quick ice axe, believe it or not. And he has Barrel of Indomitability. This is sweet. Plus 100% damage. And heals 6 points of health per turn. Frickin' awesome. That's 128. Yeah, definitely interested in that. Should be focused on me for all this stuff. Synth breastplate. Yeah. I don't like that minus to stuff like that. It's no good. Now I have an infused crystalline shard. So mine's better? No. Well, the max is greater if I use effort. The Verd. Didn't someone have something like that? Hmm. I'm not too concerned with the kind of weapon I'm using because it's... Well, I don't know. I can only use light. That's medium. Yeah, screw it. And I don't use it very often anyway. I'm usually using my spells. Whispers. Then again. 4 energy damage, plus 3. It is better. 278, which is about half of what we have. So we can get a Whispers and a Barrel of Indomitability. Right. Well, this shield, though. How's it compare with his shield? Okay. So his has less evasion. 5% less. Yeah, I gotta keep what he has. It's pretty neat looking though, but... Well, it's just a regular battle axe. He has healing sword, yeah. Reactive plate. Mucho expensivo, yes. Boggio. Limnic Rejuvenator. He has 2 good healing items. Alright, so... Sorry it takes me so long to determine this, guys, but wow, it's just... I don't have a lot of money, so I'm really trying to make sure I have the best here. So I have regular Exuvia. He has all those minuses, though. Stinks. Yeah, I don't really want that stuff, those minuses. So I guess without the minuses, I'm, as far as what he has anyway, I have the best armor. If you're saying these negatives are, like, not wanted, which is true for me. So let's get the Barrel of Indomitability and where's the other thing? Is it this? No. It's a cipher as well. Yeah.
These ciphers are killing me.
All about the healing. So let's give the cipher to someone else. For instance, he doesn't have any time here. Burning mouse. Let's give Aratus this ring. There you go. Now, she has all these things. No. I don't want to use it. I'm used to, what do you call it? Pillars of Eternity, where you can click on an item. But instead you go like this. And like this. This way, they have one. For when one just isn't good enough and you need to heal two people. We have different characters who can do it. And for that matter, give her two. Him one. Him one. There you go. They seem to be the toughest. Calistes falls, and I get damaged too, but then again, they attract a lot of attention and get hit a lot, so. But this makes it easier for us because we can just use them, you know. If more than one person needs to be healed, well then just go and do that thing.
Yes.
Anything new with this? What is this thing? Huh. The floating patch of darkness before you looks like the dying Minnim you saw earlier, only this one is even more closed, a few furled tight into a black, unblossomed rose, as if looking for something to bring it to life, and suddenly you know what that something is. Yeah, it was more of a crystalline thing before, like a shard of something. Now it's just this fog. Okay, so what is that something? The pulse in your chest, the bond from the dying Minnim below, becomes stronger in the presence of this one. The feeling of desperation is almost unbearable. It wants, needs, you to connect them. You also sense, however, that doing so will hurt you, taking from you the clarity of mind that bonding with the dying Minnim had given you earlier. You will give life to the pair, but not without a cost. What? Are these things alive? Taking from you the clarity of mind that bonding with the dying Minnim had given you earlier. Oh, so, in other words, we're going to lose some intelligence? The more you look at the Minnim, the more it seems to you like an unpollinated flower. It is dormant, and looking it for something to bring it, looking for something to bring it to life. But what? There was a slight resistance, as if you were pushing through a spider web, but otherwise nothing happens. You just end up on the other side of it, but still up on the same ledge. Alright, let's see what happens. Yeah, I lost one intelligence. Big deal. I have 20. Or had. You release your hold on the pulsing life inside you. Darkness wells up out of you, through your chest, your throat, and flooding out of your mouth. It chokes and burns, leeching energy and alertness from you, as if feeding the newborn thing with your own vitality. After what seems an eternity, the pain subsides, followed by an overwhelming feeling of relief. So we've lost, permanently lost one intellect. And do we gain it by some other way? The effect on the darkness is miraculous. It quickly becomes more diffuse, less a clot and more a cloud, expanding, unfurling, until its dark energy, dark center is revealed. And within that center, a pulsing red light and a welcoming warmth that carries with it the echoes of sounds you are not hearing around you. Walk through the space again. You step into the warm, red darkness and it swallows you, turning you into smoke and sparks. You drift and swirl through a black void, floating toward another patch of flickering red. Then suddenly you are somewhere else. Okay. So that's it's an easier way to get up there. So we traded intelligence for that. It's neat to read about, though.
Ready.
The floating darkness has awakened. Where before it was as dull and empty as an abandoned cave, now within its darkness you see a flickering red like the reflection of a fire. A comforting warmth comes from within, carrying with it the echoes of sounds you are not hearing around you. Okay, that's the boy. That's pretty cool. These things are alive and one suffers without the other. That's what I make of it. Let's see if I can talk to Vronos anymore about what we've found. Although we're not done with the quest. Since we're here. Nope.
Look out below! Above! Sideways!
Look out all over the freaking place. You have edge in these, yeah. I don't know, but when do I use that edge? I guess on, yeah, on test, the other characters do. Which is always going to be some kind of combat thing.
On it.
Cool.
Yes, now.
So we've really upgraded ourselves. Pretty neat. We actually still have 273. Yeah, I'm gonna keep it to that. Just figure there's...
Yes.
There's something else we want to get from what's-her-name.
All right.
The lady in Mila Vest who's selling things, the vendor there. We are fully rested. Oh, hello. Oh, right.
Updated my journal.
Yeah, we've gone through this. You guys can pause if you want. Shrieks for glory. So, blah blah blah, we look at all this stuff like we did before.
Fine.
Huh. Still, you're fairly certain this is the tomb of Marcissa, who's proximity to Innifer must be what inspired this display of, you hardly dare call it devotion, but it's certainly effusive. She stood watch between hope and horror and died, beloved, on her feet, in service of who we suffered. In service of we who suffer. As you reach out to touch the symbol, a spark flares from it, and you feel your tattoo blazing in symphony. The rock under the symbol evaporates as if it were transmuting itself into another dimension, revealing a large niche.
Making a note.
Oh, cool. So this was not here before. Within is a thing of strange dimensions and impossible angles, spun from an unearthly metal that seems to flow as you examine it. Its branching limbs cross in a lattice that holds no clear pattern. Tidal energies seep from it, and you recognize the sigil of the changing god stamped on its base. What else it might be? This is a mirror caster. But not one you can use, at least not now. Someone has twisted it out of alignment, and it would be impossible guesswork to return it to a proper state. The rock that covers the niche melts away, but there is nothing inside anymore. Okay, so we gotta examine that mirror caster after. After the end, or the beginning, after we end this episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time when we examine this twisting mirror caster, and After that, I'm assuming we're going through the endless gate. Although this is not an entrance to another zone. Well, it doesn't appear so on the map. It is. So thanks so much for watching, guys. Hopefully we're prepared for what lay in store for us inside here with fighting all these guys. Or maybe we can simply walk past them. In any case, it was good to, well, we had to get rid of all those oddities. Who knows, we might end up buying them back. Whenever I finish the game, I'm going to end up looking through like a walkthrough or a FAQ or something like that, FAQ, to see if there's anything we can do with these oddities, if they, because they might interact with other places, items, people, such like that. So who knows? So thanks so much for watching. See you in the next one. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.